Radio Nederland presents Netherlands Composers, a series of orchestral music by Dutch composers of our time. The program is introduced by John van der Steen.
Hendrik Andriessen is one of a family that contributed considerably to musical life in Holland. His father was a church organist, and he too started his career as an organist. Now he is also professor of musicology at the Catholic University of Nijmegen, and he was head of the Royal Conservatoire at The Hague until he had to retire at the age of 65. Hendrik Andriessen was born 70 years ago. He is a jovial man in a quiet and intellectual way, and he doesn't look his age at all. I talked to him in his study in one of the tranquil, rather classy residential districts of The Hague. He was sitting opposite me against the background of his large bookcase, packed with hundreds of the well-known yellow French paperback editions. This obvious appreciation of French literature is part of Andriessen's love for the French spirit, for French culture in general, and that, of course, includes music. He's always been rather outspoken in his preference, in particular in his youth, when musical life in Holland was still almost completely centered around the German romanticists. Hendrik Andriessen's early work shows a very strong French influence, which can be traced back to Debussy and César Franck. Like César Franck, Andriessen feels completely at ease at the keyboard of the organ. And like Franck, he has written quite a lot for the instrument. Just as an example, here is a short piece from his Concerto for Organ and Orchestra. The Amsterdam Concert Hall, the famous Concertgebouw, happens to be equipped with an organ, the one you just heard, played by the composer, by the way. But the finest organs are to be found in some of the churches of Holland, which, of course, is where an organ belongs. A great number of Andriessen's compositions were inspired by and written for the liturgy of the Roman Catholic Church. Organ music, of course, 8 masses, and several settings of hymns like the Te Deum and Magnificat. Andriessen's church music is modern, not only in its construction, but also in spirit. No ecstasy or pathos, as we find in the romantic concept of religious experience, no great outpourings of emotion. He prefers to follow the sober and cool lines of Gregorian chant. His music is direct, clear, simple. When I asked him what his favorite work was, he told me that he had especially enjoyed writing a mass in which the choral fragments are alternated with the singing of the people, which I think is significant for Andriessen's attitude towards the real function of church music, that of enabling everybody to take part. I also asked him, did he think that his being a Catholic had influenced his composing of concert music as well? Oh, undoubtedly, he said, only I honestly wouldn't know in which way. After all, you don't ask a fish whether its life has been influenced by the water, do you? Common sense is one of Andriessen's characteristics, clearly reflected in his music. There's also the thoughtful side of his nature, the calm contemplation of the organist as he sits improvising high up in the organ loft, thinking music. And then there's the energetic Andriessen, always aware of the tension music ought to have, the power hidden in it, the force of rhythm, the magic of melody. All these facets of Andriessen's personality, and therefore of his music, are in evidence in the work we are now going to hear. Symphony No. 4 by Hendrik Andriessen, played by the Amsterdam Concertgebouw Orchestra, conducted by Eduard van Beinum. There are three movements.
Thank you.
That was Symphony No. 4 by Hendrik Andriessen, played by the Amsterdam Concertgebouw Orchestra, conducted by Eduard van Beinum. The program, introduced by John van der Steen, came to you through the transcription service of Radio Nederland in Hilversum, Holland.